Good morning, Millennium. I'm Maxima Lawler, and this is what's happening on campus this week. The girls' basketball team came up big last Friday with a win over section rival Valley Vista. The girls knocked off the Monsoon 71-68 to improve their record to 18-5 on the season and perfected their conference play to 6-0 entering last night's contest against La Jolla High School. Let's take a look at the highlights.
Okay, ladies, now let's get information. Prove to me you got some coordination. Slay trick or you get eliminated. Okay, ladies, now let's get information. Prove to me you got some coordination. Slay trick or you get eliminated.
The girls return home on Friday against Copper Canyon. Tip-off is set for 7 p.m. The boys' basketball team ran their winning streak to 5 games after a 60-51 win over Valley Vista last week. Millennium's reporter James Morgan has more.
Today we're taking a W. First place.
After
holding first place.
Millennium traveled to Valley Vista Friday night, looking to keep the top spot in the 6A Southwest region.
Let's be ready to go, guys. Coach, I think
you have nothing to save your legs for, right? Everything we leave on the floor tonight,
yes,
one quarter at a time.
Yes,
we win every quarter.
Yes,
let's go, guys. Let's go.
Heart smart together on third.
1, 2, 3. Heart smart together.
Let's go.
Key players such as Justice Jackson, Deron Holmes, and Michael Batchelor led the way for the Tigers.
Justice Jackson really went between the legs to Holmes, and he fired that baby down court to Batchelor for straight cash.
Although Millennium had a large lead going into the second half, senior Monsoon point guard Mark Thurman had something to say about it. Mark Thurman converted on 5 of 5 from deep, hitting 3 threes in a row to bring the game within 2. Down the stretch, Millennium converted on 9 of 10 free throws, closing the game out with Justice Jackson going 5 of 5 from the line. Millennium will be traveling to Copper Canyon this Friday. Come out and support your Tigers. I'm James Morgan for Millennium TV.
The boys look to stay hot on Friday on the road against Copper Canyon before returning home on Tuesday to battle Tolleson. Now for a quick commercial break.
We'll be right back.
Days of Remembrance is our nation's annual commemoration of the Holocaust.
Müssen wir Selbstmusterung halten und abstoßen, was sich als schlecht erwiesen hat und es halt.
The events and the results of the Holocaust were so devastating. It was an extreme that we can barely imagine. But we remember. We remember because it is an unthinkable scar on humanity.
We gather today to mourn the loss of so many lives, celebrate those who saved them, honor those who survived, and contemplate the obligations of the living.
Guys, I got overdrive.
How'd you manage that?
Well, I was just trying to, you know, listen to my music, but the teacher didn't like that, so he just gave me overdrive for it.
Are you gonna go?
Nah, I'm just gonna skip it. They won't notice, right?
I don't think that's the best idea.
I mean, I there's a bunch of people going to overdrive every day. I mean, they won't notice me.
I'm pretty sure they will.
Yeah. Check.
Nah, guys, I'll be fine. Don't worry.
Okay.
What's going on, Josh?
Man, dude, I got two overdrives.
Oh, that's what you get for being stupid and ditching.
Didn't I tell you to go to them?
No.
Dude, I didn't think they'd find out, but they did. And I'm just gonna go ahead and skip the second one.
Are you dumb? You're just gonna get ISS.
No. I think yesterday I just got bad luck and they noticed, but this time they won't notice. There's too many.
Right, so KFOB is a service-oriented organization that we actually partner with Kiwanis International, and we serve our community in different ways, doing things like turkeys for the troops, for the lower servicemen on the Air Force Base. We help with the city of Goodyear, just helping to keep the neighborhoods picked up, painted, refreshed. So lots of opportunities around our community to help make our community a better place for students and adults. So throughout the year, we have many opportunities to attend leadership conferences to help train. We also need supplies to help engage in the fundraisers or the community service projects that we are doing. So this coming Monday night on the 29th, we'll be meeting at the new Panda Express on Camelback in Litchfield to raise some money to help support our club and many activities that we do each year.
She's a tear in my heart. I'm alive. She's a tear in my heart. I'm Joel Stratton here tonight at the girls' soccer game against Valley Vista.
We met up with Coach Cameron after the game to see what he had to say about it.
We have a lot of talent. So this is a good group of girls. We've been together. This is our third year I've been with the program. And it's a lot of the same players from 3 years ago. So we took beatings like this 3 years ago, but they overcame that. And they've grown from it. And you can see the result as tonight, what they did tonight. No, I'm not surprised.
The boys' soccer team played to a 3-3 tie last week against section opponent Westview on senior night. MTV reporter Kara Shelton has more.
I'm Kara Shelton reporting for MTV. I'm covering the boys' soccer game, which is senior night. Tonight they are playing Westview. So how do you think your team played tonight?
The team did an amazing job. They played with all their heart. They played 100%. They give everything. We almost win. We scored first. We scored second time, third time, but we were unlucky at the end. But I'm very proud of them. We have been struggling because we don't have too many seniors. But at the end of the day, we're a lot of young players, and we're going to be improving. So we're doing a great job as a team and as a coach. I'm very proud of them because they are working hard and they are showing everything on the field.
I think they put it all together finally, and we were able to see the team that we've been looking for all throughout the season. They came together, stayed together, and played an amazing game. We actually saw some great things out there.
It ended in a tie for our boys' varsity soccer game against Westview. I'm Kara Shelton, signing off.
Millennium Color Guard is in action this weekend at Williams Field High School. The Color Guard has been hard at work this year and look to come out on top in upcoming competitions. MTV reporter Kayla Markham has more.
Well, I'm Kayla Markham, and I'm interviewing Justin Enriquez from our Winter Color Guard.
What is Color Guard?
Color Guard is a combination of spinning a rifle, saber, and flag with dance and performance aspects.
How do you feel about this upcoming season?
I feel really good about the season. I really like our show concept, and so far, yeah.
Past seasons, what was your favorite show to perform?
My favorite show to perform was our recent one, which was my final gift!
Do you enjoy doing Winter Guard?
I really do enjoy doing Winter Guard.
How long have you done Color Guard?
I've done Color Guard for a little bit over a year.
Who/what inspired you to do Color Guard in the first place?
I just thought it was fun looking, so I ended up doing it, and yeah.
Continue doing Color Guard outside of high school.
Yeah, I'm going to join the ACU marching band and be in the Color Guard section.
So, Winter Color Guard has their first competition this Saturday. Make sure you go and watch them, support them. They really could use it.
Thanks for tuning in, Tigers. From all of us here at MTV, I'm Max Mulaller, and we hope to see you next week.